That right there is poison. If Bangalore was known as the city of lakes, today it should be known as the city of poisonous lakes. But polluted lakes are just one of the civic issues that voters of this city will have in mind before casting their vote on the 12th of May. What are the other issues? Let's ask them.
As the list has come out by BBC, Bangalore is number two city which will run out of the water. Government is doing nothing. No action has been taken to conserve the water in Bangalore city.
We are in the most congested junctions of Bangalore city, which is the 100 feet road. So as you can see, the huge amount of traffic that is over here. Added to this is the fact that there are no footpaths. So the footpath that you can see here is very pathetic. Vehicles are parked here, bikes are always going on the footpath, they don't go on the road. I think today the vote is going to be decided more on local issues, especially coming down to our own area. It's not even about the entire city, it's about our own areas that is going to decide.
I have three buildings right now being built on 12th May. One of them is six floors and we have the sanction plan with us. It is only sanctioned for three floors. There are two buildings on 9th Main, which is a residential road as per the master plan 2015. And they are both commercial buildings and they are all just near completion right now. You can do whatever you want as long as you have the money to do it. That's all you need. And that is not right.
We have been fighting with the Karnataka government to fix this lake, but we all see they have not been working on it. And this is all toxic fumes coming from industry effluents. We are meeting all the candidates who are going to stand from this Bengaluru area. The first agenda we are asking is clean up the Bengaluru lake. That's it.
There's a lack of coordination between the different civic agencies. Somebody has to step in and make sure that the BBMP knows what the BWSSB is doing, or X knows what Y is doing, because this is what has also made an area into a complete mess.
Foam flies all over this area and goes to the kids area, swimming pool area, sometime to the 13th and 14th floor of that building. We don't even come out for a walk. We don't let kids come out to play in the kids area. We don't go out for swimming.
The issue is improper management of garbage.
The issue is the existence of pubs and bars in the residential neighborhoods. All the illegal ones need to be kicked out.
The issue is unsustainable and illegal commercialization of residential areas.
Overload of sewage pipes. There's of course water problem because of this. And electricity is a joke. So one little rain and we don't have electricity. Huge amounts of overload on infrastructure because of this influx of people into this city.
See, the whole problem which is there today in Bangalore is that every civic body has failed us. There's no other way to work on this than to work at the state level, right?
BBMP is Congress and the state is Congress, right? So we are expecting some sort of benefits on the ground because of this combination of Congress, but that doesn't seem to be happening, right? So what is happening here is, while it is the municipal issues and BBMP can easily actually handle this, but the state government needs to support this because it finally is the Congress party we are talking about, right?
I don't think it really matters. When BJP was in power, they did exactly the same things. So, you know, whoever is coming to power, if the people change, at least they have to make sure that the rule of law is followed.
Well, we are equally dissatisfied with all the parties. Our point is that we are going to make it very clear, very, very clear to whoever is contesting from our constituency what we don't want and what we want.
So will these civic woes dig the Congress's grave in Bangalore, or will the party be able to rise and shine in the 28 seats in Bangalore of the 224-member assembly? 15th May, or counting day, will let us know.